Well, thank you very much. Andreas and I will be presenting on behalf of our colleagues. We will be talking about police ordinances and how these can be linked throughout Europe, basically, and their colonies, so basically around the world. What are police ordinances? In the early modern period, when a government of whatever hierarchical level was announcing their decisions, they asked a town crier or city crier to announce these rules. This person would walk around the city or town or even in the rural areas and would proclaim the rules. And mainly from around the 1600s, these rules would be also attached to a wall of what they called known places, and people would be able to read these texts and know what was being proclaimed and what had been decided. These come in different forms, handwritten, especially until the around 1600, printed form, and they were often assembled within large volumes. Here you can find the most important rules. They won't be complete in most cases, but they do give you a good overview of the rules that were being proclaimed. Within Western Europe, there are many projects going on or have been going on that studied the police ordinances, notably in Germany, where quite a few areas were studied within the project of Karl Herter and Michael Stolleis. As you can see on the map, there are quite a lot of areas already studied, and they have been assembled within the database created by Andreas for Polizeiordnungen. This covers about 68 states of the Holy Roman Empire, but it also includes Denmark, Sweden, Bern and Zurich. Another project in Germany is one by Wolfgang Wurst on the Reichskreise. In the Netherlands, I'm working on especially the Dutch areas, and I also did a bit on the southern Netherlands. There has been a project on Limburg. Within Belgium, there is a current ERC project that covers lordly territories in Flanders. And the Royal Commission is studying basically all the ordinances from about the 1500s till the 1800s. In Denmark, which was part of the repertorium, Jürgen Moeman Lund studied several cities and their ordinances, so it's not confined to states, but it's also something you find at local levels. And he also looked into, or started to look into, the colonial rules. And recently a project was funded within Finland, which is called COCO Laws, which studies not just the European states, but also their colonial overseas territories. What is interesting is that we all study the same type of legislation, and although there might be small differences between the countries, many comparisons could be made. So what we would like to achieve is that we create interoperable data, both for the metadata but also being able to search through full text. We are aware that we have a very versatile community and a very versatile source. So it's not just legal historians, but also political historians. Since many of these projects just run for a PhD or a postdoc, we would be eager to find ways of saving it in such a way that it would last longer than a project. And expand to adjacent fields. What we would hope for is consortium building and building an infrastructure, finding a hub where we might connect. And in the longer run, we hope for automatic metadating of full text sources and attach that to the system, to an ontology and such. So what we have within police ordinances are information about jurisdictions, date, promulgation information, institutions, the topic or matter, penalties, assemblies, and this is a versatile source relevant for many, many fields. And what we would in the end hope to deliver is a taxonomy with an hierarchical SCOS, a symbol knowledge organization system that allows for the for at least 1800 terms to be connected to both the thesaurus and data stories, and an ontology that allows room and place for various elements that we can find in these sources. So Andreas.
So I hope you can hear me. This is a short glimpse of what we took as next steps in the development. As Annemieke told you, it's very diverse projects. Each one or many of them already have their kind of database, and we try to develop a conceptual model or an ontology, first steps towards an ontology, but that was more or less improvised. And at some point we felt that we were not even sure whether we were making any progress or not. So that's why I was somehow, the two of us have taken a look at how ontologies are developed, what the perspectives, the tooling, the platforms are, and that's what I would like to talk about in the remaining minutes. So what we have found is that there's a certain that there are certain commonalities in so-called agile ontology development methods or ontology design methods, and this is that they avoid something that we had run the risk of doing, namely starting from an abstract theoretical idea of what the domain is, and then maybe implementing and engineering stuff that you are not going to need in the end. So they are strongly requirements driven. They somehow split their tasks into smaller subtasks and then do many iterations on solving those smaller problems. They use patterns of ontologies and try to develop a pattern for solving small problems, and then worry about how these patterns work together only in a second step, and worry about how the whole ontology, once that is integrated, aligns to other ontologies like CDOC-CRM even later. And many of these approaches also share a graphical editor first approach, so to say. So they try to establish these models of ontologies with a graphical editor, and then translate this with the help of the tooling to formal ontologies. So that's something that we have, that we are planning to do. The slides have somehow changed their layout. Let's see. Maybe you can fix it, or maybe you can read it better. Probably you can read it better if you have the presentation on full screen mode. But anyway, I will just go through these steps since we don't have so much time anyway. The first thing, obviously, you have an onboarding event where you somehow have the community convene and decide who wants to join, who wants to take which role. You write an introductory document explaining the common endeavor, and that is what we try to do in these days, and what we're also instrumentalizing this conference for a bit. I hope for your understanding there. The result should be on the one hand, some introductory texts or lists of existing resources in a GitHub wiki, and then a collection, that's the next step, a collection over a certain amount of time of user stories where people who are working in the domain can explain what kind of data they have and what kind of questions they want a database or a federated system to be able to answer. I've wired a Google form to the GitHub issue system so that people can enter their stories, very short explanations of their data, and it creates GitHub issues automatically for us. Based on these stories, there will be a glossary developed of key notions that helps in naming entities later on, and also in compartmentalizing, so to say, the problem into smaller problems. And then comes the iterative workflow, where a selection, only a small selection of these user stories, is picked out by developers, related and interdependent stories, and they try to develop a data model and an ontology for these few user stories. And that is then integrated. Once that is done, these are integrated with the existing models, and the whole thing resumes until all the user stories are exhausted. So that's what we imagine our workflow to be. There are some pointers to the tooling that we're thinking of. I've already told you about GitHub and Google Forms. We have not decided yet which editor we will take. At one point or another, probably Ontomi will also come into play, maybe to align the resulting ontology with, the next slide. Maybe at least to align the resulting ontology with other ontologies like CDoc CRM and so on. That is something, as I said, that these agile approaches share, that such alignment questions should be addressed only at later stages. So, but alignment is, of course, something that we want to do. The databases have to be established and populated, and then we will hopefully have something that we can present at later conferences and solicit wider feedback. So there's a link to the GitHub repository, where at the moment there's not much yet beyond contact information. And hopefully soon there's the link to the Google form. So if you are working on ordinances, have information that you would like to have accommodated in such a system, then we would enter something in this Google form linked at the GitHub page, and thus also help building up this common system. Thank you.